Hello everyone, today we are going to study the chapter Footprints Without Feet, which is from the same book. The book's name is also Footprints Without Feet, and this story was written by H.G. Wells, who is very famous author, and this story has been also very famous because it has been turned into several movies. Even in India also it was made into a movie that was named Mr. India. And let's find out what is this story whole this whole story is about, and how the events in this story unfolds. One fine morning, the two boys started in surprise at the fresh muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. One fine morning, when two boys were there out, they were actually going to somewhere, and they suddenly saw that a fresh muddy imprint was there on the stairs. And they were very much surprised to see that what a man is doing in the middle of London. And where was the man? As they gazed, a remarkable sight met their eyes. As they were looking at it, suddenly they saw something very much surprising, something that they have never seen, that a fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. Suddenly there was another footmark, and they could not see anybody walking over there. Further footprints followed one after the other, and then after that several footprints followed after that, one after the other, descending the steps and progressing down the steps. And it was actually doing what? It was descending the steps of a stair, and it was going towards the street. The boys started to follow. They were very much fascinated to see that how these imprints are actually coming up, until the muddy impressions became fainter. And after some time, the muddy impressions that were actually now coming out of because of someone moving, and to whom they could not see, it started to become fainter. It started to fade away, and at last disappeared altogether. The explanation of the mystery was really simple enough. And why was this whole thing happening? How this whole thing was happening? It was very simple to know that the bewildered boys had been following a scientist, and they did not know that they were actually following somebody who's a scientist, who had just discovered how to make a human body transparent. And the scientist, someone who had actually discovered a medicine that after consuming that thing, a human body could become transparent. And that's how they were actually following a scientist, not somebody, not a ghost or not something like that, but actually they were following a scientist, and that's how the mystery was there. Next, Griffin the scientist had carried out experiment after experiment to prove that the human body could become invisible. It was the scientist's name was Griffin. He had carried out several experiments to prove that the human body could also become invisible, and it was the effect of that experiment only. Finally, he swallowed the certain rare drugs, and his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass. And he actually tested that medicine on himself only. He swallowed that drug, and he became as transparent as a sheet of glass. Nobody could actually you can see what is there behind him, though it also remained as solid as glass, but still it was solid. He became invisible, but he was still solid. Brilliant scientist though he was very much brilliant. Definitely he was brilliant, someone who had actually discovered a medicine that how to make a human body invisible. Definitely that person must be very intelligent. Griffin was rather a lawless person, but he was a lawless person, that somebody who always broke the law. His landlord disliked him, and that is why that was the reason his landlord never liked him and tried to eject him. He always tried to throw him away out of his house. In revenge, Griffin set fire to the house. And after once he consumed that medicine, he became invisible. He always wanted to take revenge from his landlord. So what he did, he set his house on fire, and to get away without being seen, he had to remove his glass. And definitely if he wanted to run away from that place, then what he had to do, he had to remove his glass, because if somebody would see him, then definitely he will be caught. Thus it was that he became a homeless wanderer. And definitely after that, what happened when he removed all the clothes and ran away from that place? So he became a homeless wanderer. He had no home, without clothes, without money, and quite invisible, until he happened to step in some mud. And until his foot stepped into some mud, and that's how he became his foot imprints became a little bit visible and left footprints as he walked. So this is how the whole thing has happened, and this is how the boys were actually following a scientist whose name was Griffin, who had invented a medicine that makes the human body invisible. He escaped easily enough from the boys who followed his footprints in London, but his adventures were by no means over. Though he escaped from the eyes of the boys, but whatever he was doing, that his adventures were not over yet. He had chosen a very bad time of the year, and definitely you can wonder that somebody without the clothes on the streets of London, and it was midwinter, it was very chilly air, the air was bitterly cold, and he could not do without clothes. Definitely what must he have been feeling over there, because during winter, if you are without clothes and if you are walking down on the street, and if you are not even having a house, definitely you know what are you going to feel. So something like that was also happening with this scientist also. Instead of walking about the street, he decided to slip into a big London store for warmth, and definitely he also wanted to save himself. So what he did, instead of walking on the streets, he decided to step into a big London store, and so that he could actually have some warmth, he could actually have some cloth, he could actually have some food also. As soon as the closing time arrived, the doors were shut. Griffin was able to give himself the pleasure of clothing and feeding himself without regard to expense. As soon as the staff of the store went away, then Griffin did what? He found whatever the clothing that he got there, he wore those clothing without the expense, because nobody was there, so he had not to pay anything. He broke open boxes, whatever the boxes he got, he broke open everything and wrappers, and fitted himself out with warm cloths, and whatever the cloths that he got, he tried to fit himself in that one. Soon with shoes and overcoat and a wide brimmed hat, and very soon he found everything over there in the big store. He found shoes also, he found an overcoat also, a wide brimmed hat also. He became fully dressed, and definitely what happened now, he was totally visible person. In the kitchen of the restaurant, he found cold meat and coffee, and he was very much lucky that in that big store there was a kitchen also, and in the restaurant he found some cold meat, some coffee, and after that he found some sweets also, some wine also. He found everything over there, so that was the night of luxury for him. He spent a very beautiful night in the London store, and definitely after having all those things, all the food and all the sweets, and after that he got a lot of quills also. After having the wine, he went on to sleep. If only he had managed to wake up in good time all night. Had he actually woken up early in the morning, perhaps he would not have been caught. But since he had taken a lot of wine also, and he had got warmth after a long hour, after walking on the streets naked, so definitely he had felt what a chill is, and how the bitter cold air actually stings to your body. So that's why he could not wake up in the morning. And what happened? As soon as the assistants were there in the store in the morning, when he saw a couple of them, he started to run away, because he was now worried that what is this happening? If they actually caught him, then he would land into a jail. So that is why he started to run away from that place. As soon as he started to run away, what happened? He panicked and he began to run. They naturally gave the chase. The staff of the London store, they also started to chase him. In the end, he was able to escape only because by quickly taking off his newly found clothes. So what he did, he quickly removed all the clothes, and that's how he became once again invisible, so that no one could actually find him. So, and then again, he was in the same manner, he was naked in the chilly air of January. This time he decided to try the stock of a theatrical company, but he actually did not lose his hope. This time he decided to go to a theatrical company where he thought that he could find some clothes also, as well as some extra materials also, like he could actually so that his face could also be visible. So he tried to go to there. He went to the Drury Lane and he entered into a shop of Theatre World. He soon found a suitable shop. He made his way invisible upstairs and he quickly went upstairs and came out a little later wearing bandages around his forehead. After some time he came out and he was wearing a lot of bandages around his head. Dark glasses, false nose, big bushy side whiskers and a large hat. He was wearing a lot of clothes also. To escape without being seen, he carelessly attacked the shopkeeper from behind. And since he wanted to escape from that place, so what he did, he attacked on the shopkeeper. And after attacking, he robbed him of all the money that he could. And whatever was there, he actually robbed him off and then after that ran away from that place. So that's how he now did another misadventure. That was something he was very much habitual of doing. One after the other, he was actually committing a crime. Definitely he was committing what? He was committing a crime. So he did, he committed another crime over here. So that's how now he ran away from that place also. Now he had the idea, now he was thinking that where he should go. So he decided to move to countryside. He decided to move to a village. Eager to get away from the crowded London, he took a train to village of Iping, and from there only he was very much eager to leave that place, and he took a train to a village. That village name was what? It was named Iping, where he booked two rooms at the local inn. Where he actually booked two rooms in a local inn, and during the arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. And somebody in winter comes to that Iping village, it was very much unusual. Everybody knew that no one comes here during the winters, and they hardly had a visitor over there. A stranger of such uncommon appearance set all the tongues wagging, and definitely all the people were in the Iping village, they were talking about it, that someone very strange has come to that inn. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly, and since he was the guest of Mrs. Hall, who was the wife of the landlord, so Mr. Hall, and definitely she was trying to make every effort to be very friendly with him, because she wanted to earn some money. That was the purpose. But Griffin had no desire to talk and told her, my reason for coming to Iping is a desire for solitude. And he actually told her that why he had come to this place, he wanted to be alone. He wanted some solitude, he wanted some peace, and that is why he does not wish to talk to anyone. I do not wish to be disturbed. He told her that he doesn't want to be disturbed in his work. Besides, an accident has affected my face, and even definitely everybody would ask that what has happened to your face, why have you covered it with lot of bandages. So he told about that also. It was due to an accident that he has covered his face, and after some time when it is okay, he will remove it. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse the strange habits and irritable temper. And definitely she was very much happy to see a visitor in the winter season, because nobody came during the winters. So she was very much happy. Even she was whenever she saw him, his tempers, he was very much irritating, he was very much strange, his habits were strange. So she thought of, okay, let it go, whatever is there, his habit, let it be. Because she was very much happy with the money, because he had paid her in advance. But the stolen money did not last long. But whatever the money that he had stolen from that place, from the theater shop, that did not go for a long time. And presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready cash. And when the time passed, Mrs. Hall was asking for the rent after some time. Then definitely he had to tell her that he was not having any money. He pretended, however, that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. But he told her, no, don't worry. I am going to get some money. My check is coming after some time. So don't worry, I'll pay you. So that's how Mrs. Hall was also thinking, okay, maybe he might be having some source of income. He might be having some source from where the money would come to him. So definitely she was also ready to let him live. But so many curious events happened after that. The very first curious event happened what? there was a clergy in the Iping village, and one fine morning what happened shortly after that one fine morning a very curious episode occurred. Very early in the morning of a clergyman and his wife were awakened by the noise in the study. One fine morning, the clergyman, the priest of the church and his wife, they were awakened by a noise in the study. Creeping downstairs, they heard the chink of money being taken from the clergyman's desk. And as soon as they came down, they could hear that someone was trying to get the money from his desk without making any noise. And with the poker grasped firmly in his hand, the clergyman flung open the door. So they wanted to catch the thief red-handed, but and so that is why they did not made any noise. They did not make any noise, and they just came down. They were having a poker, a kind of a stick in their hand, and they grasped it. They actually took it firmly, and they just came to that room and this shouted surrender, but they could not see anybody there. So that's how they were very much surprised to see that they have actually seen somebody taking away the money, and even the drawer was open, even the money was not there. But how come that money, that man, that someone who has stolen, he can suddenly disappear? Then to his amazement, he realized that the room appeared to be empty, and he was very much surprised to see that no one was there in the room. The money was gone. And what was, how the these all things has happened? He and his wife looked under the desk. They all started to look under the desk, that perhaps somebody was hiding over there. And behind the curtains, they looked at behind the curtains, behind the door. Whatever they tried to see, like whatever they felt that somebody might be hiding behind it, they tried to look everywhere. There wasn't a sign of anybody, but no one was there in the house. Yet the desk had been opened. Yet they were very sure of it, that the desk was opened and the housekeeping money was missing. The money was also not there. It was very much extraordinary affair, something that they had never imagined, that such a thing would happen. And the man was also nowhere to be seen. The clergyman kept saying for the rest of the day. He actually kept on talking to himself only, how can this happen, that nobody was there in the house? They could see the drawer being opened, they could see the money being stolen, but still they could not see the man. How can this thing happen? So he was very much upset for the whole day, and that's how this the news spread to whole Iping very quickly. But it was not extraordinary, as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later in the morning. That morning only, there was another curious episode. That was the curious episode of Mrs. Hall's furniture. When suddenly what happened, the landlord and his wife were up very early and were surprised to see the scientist's door wide open. When that very morning, the landlord and his wife, they woke up very early, and they saw that the scientist's door were open. So they thought of looking into the room, that what was he actually having in the room. Usually it was shut and locked. Normally what used to be there, it was always shut and it was locked also. So they did not have any idea that what was going on in that room. And he was very furious if anyone entered his room. So and they were very much like fearful of this thing also, that if someone entered into his house, he became very angry. He always became furious on that person. The opportunity seemed too good to be missed. And when they saw the door was open, they thought that we must not miss this opportunity, and we must find out what is there in his room. So that's how they actually entered into his room to find out what was there in it. But when they entered into it, there was something else waiting for them. They peeped around the door, saw nobody, and decided to investigate. And as soon as they actually peeped into the house, they found that nobody was there. So they decided to enter into the room, and they decided to find out what was there. The bedclothes were cold. When they entered into the room, they could actually sense that the bedclothes were very cold, that no one was there. Definitely, if you find the bedclothes to be cold, that means no one was sleeping on it, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. And stranger still, and the stranger was also, the cloths and the bandages that he always wore lying about the room. And definitely what they could see something else also over there, that the stranger, whatever the cloths and the whatever the bandages that he used to wear all the time, that was also lying about the room. All of a sudden, Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to her room, and suddenly Mrs. Hall heard something, someone sniffing, someone actually taking a breath close to her ear. A moment later, the hat on the bedpost leaped up and dashed into itself into her face. And suddenly after that, they saw that a hat suddenly leaped up from the bed and dashed towards their face. Then the bedroom chair became alive. And after that, the bedroom chair also started to move, springing into the air and charged straight at her. And suddenly the chair jumped up and it actually started moving towards her. Legs foremost, its legs were actually in front. As she and her husband turned away in the terror, the extraordinary chair pushed them both out of the room. And as soon as they saw that how the things in the room were actually moving, they were jumping, they were pushing in them, and they were actually running towards them, they ran out of the house. And suddenly what happened, then appeared the slam and locked the door after them. And as soon as they were out of the room, the door was closed itself and it was locked itself. Nobody was there, though they could not see anybody in the room, but they could see the things happening in the room. Mrs. Hall almost fell down the stairs in hysterics. And Mrs. Hall was now, she was like, oh my God, what is this happening? No one was there in the room. Even how can the chair move? She was convinced that the room was haunted. Now she was very much convinced that some ghost or something like that was there in that room, and the stranger had somehow caused these to enter the furniture. And it was the stranger only who has done all these things. It was due to the stranger that his chair and her whatever the things were there in the room, they were now discharging over them. So that's all. They had actually now another thing in their mind, that perhaps he had bewitched everything. Perhaps he had done some magic on the chair and on the hat and on everything, and that is why they were moving. My poor mother used to sit on that chair. She started crying. Oh my God, my mother used to sit on that chair. She moaned. To think it should rise up against me now. And now she was saying, I had never imagined that this chair would rise against me. The feeling among the neighbors was that the trouble was caused by witchcraft. And the neighbors were also thinking about that thing also, that somebody must have done some witchcraft, some magic, some black magic somebody must have done, and this must have been done by that stranger only. But witchcraft or not, when news of the burglary at the clergyman's home became known, the strange scientist was strongly suspected of having had a hand in it. But soon after, when they discovered about the burglary in the house of clergyman, they were all very much actually sure about it, that this man must have had hand into that also. And suspicion grew even stronger when he suddenly produced some ready cash. And even Mrs. Hall and Mr. Hall, they were suspicious after when they saw that he was giving them money also. Before some days only, he was telling them that he was not having any money, and he was expecting some money. But how come now he is actually this morning having money, though he had admitted that not long before that he had no money? The village constable was secretly sent for, and secretly what happened, the village constable was called. Instead of waiting for the constable, Mrs. Hall went to the scientist, who had somehow mysteriously appeared from his empty room. And after, she actually did not wait for the constable. She herself thought of inquiring that what was it happening. She went to the scientist, and he somehow appeared from his room, because no one has seen him going into the room, but he actually mysteriously came out of that room. I want to know what you have been doing to my chair upstairs, she demanded. And she said to him, What you have been doing to my chair? Why my chair was moving towards me? Why was it discharging towards me? And I want to know how it is you came out of an empty room and how you entered a locked room. And you just tell me that how you actually entered into that room and how you locked it and how you came out of that locked room. Just tell me everything. So this is something that she was trying to ask to that stranger. Now she was actually trying to inquire that whatever the wrong was happening over there, why was something like that he was involved into it. The scientist was always quick-tempered. Now he became furious. You don't understand who or what I am, he shouted. Very well, I'll show you. So the scientist was always, he was very much quick-tempered. He always became very angry very quickly. So he said to her, you don't know who I am, he shouted at her. And well, I will show you who I am. Suddenly he threw off bangles, whiskers, spectacles and even nose. It took him only a minute to do this. And suddenly he again started doing what? Again started throwing all the cloth that he was wearing. He threw his whiskers, he threw his spectacles and even the nose, and it took him only a minute. The horrified people in the bar found themselves staring at the headless man, and suddenly everybody could see that there was a man, someone who was having a shoulder, someone who was having hands, someone who was having feet, but no head at all. And everybody was actually very much surprised. Mr. Jeffers, the constable now arrived. Until now, the constable, whose name was Mr. Jeffers, he had also arrived and was quite surprised to find that he had to arrest a man without a head. And then when he found out that he had to arrest somebody that who was not having a head, he was also very much surprised to hear that. And definitely he was also worried about it, that how he's going to catch that man. But Jeffers was not easily prevented from doing his duty. But definitely, since he had to do his duty, so he thought of catching the man. If a magistrate's warrant ordered a person's arrest, then that person had to be arrested with or without his head. So definitely, if the person is having his head or he is not having his head, definitely that doesn't matter. If he is having an order, then he has to arrest that man. There followed a remarkable scene as the policeman tried to get hold of a man who was becoming more and more invisible as he threw off one garment after the another. And when he tried to chase him, what he found out that he was throwing one after the other garment, and he was now becoming more and more invisible every moment. Finally, a shirt flew into the air, and after some time what he could find that a shirt actually flew into the air, and suddenly the man vanished from that place. Nobody was there to be seen. Now he was very much worried that how can this man be invisible. Constable found himself struggling with someone he could not see at all, and now he found out what, that he was actually fighting with a man. He was actually trying to catch a man whom he could actually not see. Some people tried to help him but found themselves hit by blows that seemed to come from nowhere. Some people tried to help him to catch the man, but when they tried to catch him, he actually gave them a punch, and they were suddenly looking here and there that how, where that punch has come from. In the end, Jeffers was knocked unconscious as he made a last attempt to hold on to the unseen scientist. And in the end, what happened, Jeffers was, he actually knocked him heavily, and that's how Jeffers was feeling unconscious. There were nervous excited cries of hold him, but this was easier said than done. Griffin had shaken himself free, and no one knew where to lay hands on him. And after that, definitely everybody was like excited, like hold him. Everybody was saying that catch him. But definitely it were easy to say, it was easy to say that catch him, but nobody was able to catch him. And he has shaken himself and he has freed himself, and no one knew and where the Griffin the scientist was, and no one actually could catch him. After that, he ran away from that place. So after that also he did a lot of adventures. So when you read the whole book, you'll find out what is there in it. So let's find out the question and answer also. Right now only let's discuss that thing also. What is there in the question and answer? Griffin was rather a lawless person. Comment. So definitely lawless means somebody who always broke a law. You must have seen how many laws he had broken from the beginning. Only once he had actually, very first he has burned the house of his landlord. Then after that he entered into a big London store, he stole from there. After that he entered into a theater shop. Over there also he hit the shopkeeper, and after that he stole the money. He had done a lot of lawlessness. So that's how we can definitely say that he was a lawless person. How would you assess Griffin as a scientist? Griffin as a scientist was really brilliant because he had discovered a medicine by consuming that someone can be totally transparent, as transparent as a sheet of glass. That was definitely a very big invention. But being a scientist was not something enough because he was a lawless person also. Would you like to become invisible? What advantages and disadvantages do you foresee if you did? So it is totally your answer. You are going to imagine about it and you are going to write it. Are there forces around us that are invisible? For example, magnetism. Are there aspects of matter that are invisible or not visible to the naked eye? What would the world be like if you could know, if you could see such forces or such aspects of matter? So are there such forces? Definitely there are so many forces, like magnetism is there, electric field is there. So even in science you'll find so much. But can you feel those forces that you cannot see actually from your naked eyes? What would the world be like if you could see such forces or such aspects of matter? Like suppose gravity is also something like that, only that you cannot see but you can feel it. So what will happen if you can see all these forces? What will happen to the world? Imagine, it's your imagination also. Again, it's kind of imaginary question that you are going to totally imagine, and then you are going to write what makes the glass or water transparent. So you are going to think about this thing also. Okay, so you are going to write this one also. Write all these answers. Do one thing, this is your homework. Write all these answers and send it to me on the WhatsApp group only. Fine. Everybody, this is your homework, that you are going to write all these answers and you are going to send it into the WhatsApp group at 4 o'clock. Fine. So thank you guys. Meet you all in the next class on Monday, and see you all at 10:15 for live interaction if you had any doubt. After this also I am sharing another video also, that you're going to watch it and tell me whether you liked it or not, whether was it convenient for you to understand the whole chapter or not. So thank you once again. Jai Hind, everyone.